Microsoft Teams is a neat application that allows you to create teams to achieve tasks. The tasks themselves can be broken down into subtasks, which is useful if you're using project management software. You can allocate team members to each of these subtasks, and the software allows you to provide resources for the team members, documents, files, web links, and for each task or subtask. The software is included in Microsoft Office 365 and is simply called Teams. Log on to your Microsoft Office portal and select Teams. Once opened, you can either work on it online or download it for offline working. Just click on the button here. On the bar down the left-hand side, you can select Activities, Chat, Teams, Messages, and Files. The first thing we need to do is to create a team, so let's start there. Click on the big bold square to start creating your team. Let's create a team to organise the staff barbecue. And that's the name I'm going to give it. It's probably one of the most contentious things to organise, so I don't want just anybody volunteering to join the team. I want to select individuals and invite them personally. So I choose this method here. To add my first team member, I open up a conversation with Jonathan to invite him to join this select group. I'm giving him the job of managing the budget, always the worst task, and so to help him, I'm going to create an Excel spreadsheet and put it in the Files section so all the team members can see how much they can spend on their allocated tasks. But before I share it with everyone, I want to check that Jonathan is happy with it. So I share it in chat with Jonathan first. I chat with him directly and with him only. And Teams tells me it's shared. You'll see along the top here, there are some tabs that Teams has already given us. I'm going to add an extra tab for websites and use that tab to see if I can suggest some food. By clicking the plus sign, I get a couple more options. The tab I want is the website tab. I'm going to call the tab Google, just so that we can work together from inside Teams, and put in the correct URL. And there it is. I can now use Google to search from inside Teams. Food ordering online gives me some great choices from Bangkok. So I suggest to Jonathan that it might be fun to order the food from there. Actually, I'm just joking. Now, I'm going to need another team member. Let's invite William Pote. I go to the Teams section and click Add More People. Teams emails William suggesting he might join, and soon after I get a reply from William asking to join the team. Great. I can add him. Next, I want to focus the work of the team. There are three essential tasks to complete. One is to decide on what drinks to buy, the next is to decide on the food, and finally, we need to book a venue. So I'm going to create three new task areas, or channels as Teams calls them. One for drinks, one for buying food, and one for a decision on a venue. So, to recap, I've got three team members, myself, Jonathan and William. I've shared an Excel spreadsheet with the team so we can keep track of the budget. And I've broken the job down into three major areas, food, drink and venue. Now, there's only one more thing I need to do, and that's to arrange an online meeting to kick things off. And Teams can do that for me also. That's great for remote working. I go to the Schedule a Meeting tab on the bottom left, and a new window opens up. I'm hoping to run it from the boardroom. As for a time, I suggest the end of the working day. It is the staff barbecue we're discussing, so I choose a convenient time, make sure that I've got the correct time zone, and down at the bottom here, I put in a brief agenda. We're going to use the general channel for the meeting. And I'm going to invite both Jonathan and William. And there it is. Teams has emailed them with the proposed date and time and the possible agenda, and I'll wait to get their responses. Well, this is really a very brief introduction to the Teams application. It can handle a lot more people, a lot more areas and groups, and it can do a great deal more. You can match it with proper project management software if you want. Well, we'll leave you to explore it. You can always contact eTop Technology for advice. We're here to help. If you like these videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you found this video helpful, check out some of our more recent videos. And if you're looking for a new IT partner, please visit our website.